Well, hi everyone. Welcome to the Law and the Promise. We're going to get right into it today. We're going to look at the presidential election in the United States through point of view of principle. Okay. So, to start with, those of us who see individuals such as Kamala Harris, is trying, she's sincerely trying to be one with God. She would keep saying we must move forward unburdened by the past, which is just another way of saying the past is forgiven and forgotten. Okay, but she said it in a way because she thinks like, a man, that she's intellectual. She's smarter than everyone else. Okay. And the more that people think that they're smarter than everyone else, the dumber they become. And they start saying that other people are dumb because they think they're smarter than everyone else. And this is the boomerang effect because it's not based in love, because it's you've separated yourself from God and are thinking of man things, then you get that. Okay. That's what you get. It bounces off the one you intended it for, and you become that. Hence the reason that as they called Donald Trump a fascist and Hitler, the more their message came across as fascist and Hitler. Okay? They stopped listening to the people. They stopped showing respect to the people. They acted like they didn't give a damn. You're too stupid to know that you got it good. They make up excuses. Well, the whole world went through inflation. Yes, the whole world went through COVID, we know. But and they sit there and tell you that, everything got inflated. The inflation happened because of that. And that, whereas inflation will never go down, it has stabilized. And that's not true. We had a depression that proved that. Everything deflated. That is their worst nightmare. So they won't say that. They said the Great Recession because they didn't want anyone to think that it was deflating. Okay. And it didn't really deflate. They pushed the inflation to the rest of the world and stagnated here. Right? And in order to stop any deflation, they keep inflating. All right? And then in their rush to control, which is what they're trying to do, they're trying to control their minds, they're trying to control the actions, the conduct of others, and not themselves. It's you, not others. Others are showing you what you think of you because there's only one. All right, there's only one. God and man are interchangeable, and there's only one man. There's not 8.5 billion. There's not. I don't care what they tell you. There's lies, then lies, and statistics. And they're all lies. They're lies. Okay, every single one of them. You can slice it and dice it any way you want. It's still a lie. Okay? They lied to themselves because they're in their own little echo chamber. Okay? And they think they're better than everyone else, and they think they know best, and they think they're more godlike than anyone else. This is man thinking. Okay? It's not balanced. All right. There are certain things that are eternal. Yes, there's intelligence. That's a state of being. There's imagination, and that is a state of being. But they are eternal states of being. Okay. Certain states are eternal. And imagination is one, and intelligence is another. Ants. ENCE. That's a state. That's what it means. It's a state. Intelligence means curly-haired woman. In the state of the curly-haired woman, you're in the state of being a curly-haired woman. Beauty. Okay, beauty is in the eye of the beholder. The eye stands for the intellect of man, and it stands for it, the principle, awareness. Okay, it stands for imagination. It's a placeholder. All words are. Okay, to put any words to God, any kind of description is to limit him. So you describe what is, okay? Life is. This is eternal. Man and woman. Woman is. They are. Okay? This is eternal. Now, they think they can go be anything in their imagination. No, you can't. Once a dog, always a dog. Once a woman, always a man or woman. You're the man. And these are the two sides of the man and woman. Okay? And the woman represents the imaginative creative force, and the man represents the consciousness. They represent. They're an allegory. It's a story. It's a parable. Because you can't possibly see something that's ineffable, which is what the I also stands for. It's an it. It's nothing. It's has no form. It's the all. It's the O, it's zero. Okay. And in men's world, you can add to zero or subtract from zero. Okay. But that's not true. You can't add or subtract to something that is perfect. You can't add to perfect and you can't subtract from perfect. It's not possible. Okay. It's just not possible. So you think about the things that are priceless because it's priceless. Noble things, wonderful things, magical, wonderful things, so that God can reveal himself to you. He will reveal himself to you. He's inside you. He wants to show you these things. And this is where desires come from. He desires to show himself to you through this medium. Okay, so how are you going to do that? By accepting and knowing that it's already there. It's always been there. It's just that it was veiled. It was veiled. And now it's unveiling itself. And it started unveiling itself the moment you spoke the word. God is the word, and the word comes to life. God is the carpenter. God is Jesus. Okay? And he builds like a hand builds things. And you can put layer after layer after layer after layer on top of stuff. But it will all come tumbling down if it doesn't have a good foundation. Okay? And the foundation is consciousness, is the rock. Now, what you get to choose, are you going to be conscious of? What are you going to be aware of? You don't have to be aware of anything. And it's best that you're not. Okay? As little as possible. And dismiss it, forgive it, revise it. This is the great negation because you can't really know what God is, but you can know what he's not. Okay? And you can say that with great conviction. He's the eternal truth. Okay, he's beauty. Just as you see the universe outside of you, and it all works beautifully and harmoniously. It's a thing of beautiful lights. That's you. Okay, that's you. You projected that out. That's inside you. The universe and all within it is inside you. And this was the great discovery of the Lord Shiva. Now, this is the great truth that Jesus taught. Okay, God in man, here walking the earth. Well, that's us. That's all of us. Just as Jesus taught us, you're no different than Jesus. You are Jesus, God in man. You don't really have a body. You just think you do. Okay, and you think it can break and get old and get wrinkly and all this other stuff. And that's not true. That's simply not true. You're all things. You can be anything. So this is, the stories of the skinwalkers. That's what we are. The skeletons, the ghosts, the things you can't see, you're not afraid of. You don't be afraid of them because it's God. It's love. God grabbed a thought and ran with it. He works through man. He doesn't have eyes. You do. The man does. He made this suit so that he could see, so he could objectify and be objective about his thoughts and beliefs and determine, discern which ones stay and which ones go. It's not to get personally involved, it's to be objective. We've come full circle. The word knowledge in Greek is gnosis, and they bit the fruit from the tree of knowledge. Okay. And science, the word science means the state of knowing. Okay. That's what it means. You can't be all and know all if you are busy dicking with the detail. So the presidential election, many imagined Kamala winning, and they figured with all their heart that was going to happen. And it did not. Okay. And many thought Trump had everything stacked against him, but they still believed in the good that he had in him to do what was needed. And then they saw the hand of God protect him. Okay. Three assassination attempts. Okay. Three of them. And still, the people did not turn on the others. Okay. No, they praised God. They thanked God. They focused on what they thought was best. Okay. And many will say, well, he was attacking her. And well, you're not listening. Okay. You're not listening with ears that can hear. You're busy with your own point of view. Therefore, you cannot hear. Okay. You need to set aside your own point of view and listen to what he says. Okay, he's attacking personality. He's attacking policy. But he wasn't disparaging the person, just the personality. Okay, just the personality. And no one needs to get to know a personality. You're either speaking truth or not. Okay. And truth are eternal. So he was speaking eternal truths. That we want peace, we want joy, and we can do this another way. There is another way to do this. He is a messenger from God. And everyone could feel that, okay, that walk with God or at least try to. And it resonated with them. And they ran with it. And they didn't care what other people had to say about it. I don't care what you personally think, your point of view. That has nothing to do with any of this. Okay? You thinking someone is a racist does not make them a racist. That's just you telling the world that you're the racist. That's what you see. That's the vision that you hold of others. No one likes that. Because if you can call one a racist, then you see that in all. And we saw this play out, you know, in the January 6th cruel and unusual punishment. That is cruel and unusual punishment. We all know that. We don't like it. We want those people let go. We want them let go and as if it never happened again. Okay? And we don't really want to draw blood from anyone who did that. No, we'll just eliminate you. We'll reorg you out. You're not necessary. Okay? You think you are, and you're afraid you're not. So you get what you get, which is your fear that you're not, and so you're not. Certain things are essential. They're of the essence, okay? But certain things are not. And you listen to the people, because wisdom comes from the people. You don't need intellect to be wise. You don't need a university professor if you're a janitor. But a university professor needs a janitor. Okay? Garbage men, plumbers, truck drivers that bring food from the ports, all these things, they need them. Those people need each other, but they all know they don't need anyone who thinks that they're better than them. There is no authority other than I, the one and only one, I, it. It's divine life. Okay, it's the essence of life. You see the results of the essence of life. So life is prosperous. The essence makes it prosperous. It's the essence that makes it abundance. So you state, I am prosperous. I am abundant. I am beauty. I am rich. I am wealth. I am health. And it's now, right this minute. The biggest enemy is time. Time and space, they don't exist. Only in the minds of men. They're not real. And it's easy to see that because time changes all the time. God is sure and true. Truth, change. Less. So the things that are changeless are true. And for men, that's the test of time. Over time, you can see that Donald Trump has remained true to himself, true to everyone around him, truth and love. He's loved them all. With all his heart, with all his soul, with all his being. Some learn about these things from gurus, and they don't get it all. And so it falls apart. That's how you learn. It's not truth. Okay? She was not speaking from her heart. She was doing what other people told her to do. And it showed. No one wants someone like that in charge, leading, because we don't know who's telling her what to do, that she's parroting. No, you want one who's listening to God, because God's telling that one what to do. We saw this happen in El Salvador. Okay. You have only to look at El Salvador to see the instant change in that country from decades and decades of being brutalized to safe and secure once again. They elected a man of God who surrounded himself with men who walk with God, and now things are turning around. They pray before they go out. No innocents get hurt. Okay, we want to protect innocence. That's how it is, because no one wants anyone to go into the song of experience. They can help it keep that innocence pure and beautiful and lovely. That's what men want. Okay, you leave my children alone. You let them determine for themselves what is right and true. They can do it all by themselves with my guidance. And if I'm not guiding them, somebody will step up to guide them. And I will love them for being there for my child when I could not be. What you witnessed was the hand of God at work and hearing the cry of men. Okay? And it is a new age to start all over again. And here we go. It's going to be wonderful. And it's going to be God's country once again. Not because Donald Trump's in charge, but because men of God are in charge. And men who refuse to walk with God and listen to others who had no eyes who could see and no ears that could hear. You know, they just get pushed to the wayside. And we all hope that they will turn around and see God and not be afraid. Do not be afraid. You can stand in that light. It's okay. The fire that burns the point of view away is the truth. This is the fire they fear, the fire that lights but does not burn. When you look in the mirror, you should see the sun shining and the rays coming out of your head. You should see that in all men and all as well. No one's going to be punished like they fear. This is their fear talking. They've let their imaginations run wild, and somebody just needs to slap them and tell them, stop being hysterical. You're being ridiculous. Now, Kamala was quite wonderful in her acceptance speech and her conceding the election to Trump. It was a beautiful speech. Okay. They haven't given up. You know, they haven't. But we're going to rise higher and find another way. One reflects the other. Understand this. What are you going to reflect? Men? And there are things that come and go that change all the time? Or are you going to reflect the changeless, the beauty, the glory, the magnificence of life? You dominate with wisdom. Okay. We learn from the Bible, which is God's word, that God works through men. All things wonderful come to those who seek wisdom. Okay. You ask God for wisdom. This is the story of King Solomon. And he gives it to you, all of it. And you then have the intellect to know and how to discern what is truth and what is not, and you are able to have the most wonderful life that ever could be. And to remember that whatever you build, you can hand off to someone else and go off with your love. So I hope this helps. Blessings to you. Thank you. Thank you for being you.